I am SuperDraco380, and welcome back to Why, the show where I don't always have an answer to that question. So today we're building a not-Lego steam locomotive. The brand name is G-Star or G-Star. I'm not sure how you pronounce that. Probably butchered it. Sorry to Chinese people or whoever's language that is. I assume it's Chinese. So, long story short, this is like a knockoff Lego steam locomotive. Now, to answer the question of why, I didn't buy this. My mother gave it to me as a Christmas present because, well, and to quote, because she thought it looked neat. And I guess she got it off Temu or somewhere. So, I've never built a Lego-style train before, so we're going to jump into it. Sorry about the abrupt audio cut. My mic is being weird again today. So I'm just cutting the problems and restarting. So, you know, the bags. Now, this set's weird, and this is part of how you can tell it's a knockoff, because it didn't come in a box. It came in a bag. A big bag with a series of smaller bags in it, because, hey, let's waste plastic. Now, this is weird. Unlike Lego, I could not rip these bags, so I'm using my Damascus knife there, or style knife, to open it. I love that knife. Anyway, and as you can see, it's incredibly sharp. So don't wave it around and be like a moron like I do. So, interestingly, all these parts come in individually bags, 1-1 through 1-5. And now we're going to get to it later, but I believe this thing actually may have been meant to be motorized. Because there's a few mechanisms in here that don't do anything. They're honestly entirely unnecessary, unless this was copied from something that had a motor option. Which is both very cool, tempting, but also just no. Because I don't need a bunch of Lego tracks, I don't need another obsession right now on top of Transformers and Gundam and everything else. Essentially, starting out the build, those lime green parts are all, they're stoppers to make sure that certain axles can't rotate and stuff during the build. And that in itself doesn't make it seem to be motorized, but there's a linkage that you put two small gears onto that sticks out the top of it into a relatively hollow area. And that's why I think this might be meant to be or capable of being motorized. Am I ever going to take advantage of it? Probably not. But anyhow, now, if y'all remember the Titanic from last Christmas that I couldn't finish because of how horrible the instructions were. Well, spoiler alert, these instructions, they're not that bad. I'm able to build this with one exception that's going to get a moment of anger later. But with one exception, I really didn't have near as much trouble with this as I did with the Titanic. But I think that's because, A, these are actually full size, actual proper Lego size, and not that miniature size, and B, that you're not just layering up layers and layers and layers of plates, and instead that it's a combination of plates and actual bricks. So So this part goes fairly smooth. I might make some cuts, but my voice isn't holding up super good, so I'm probably going to just stop talking and we'll do this chill style because I really don't have a problem for a while. So yeah. So we'll do this as a chill build. Thanks for watching. Check out my fantasy story on Fiction Press. Username is exactly the same as YouTube. Super in all caps, Draco380. Thanks for watching, thanks for reading, and I'll see you in the next video, and hopefully my voice is holding up a little better.